Hello everyone, welcome to the NCERT audiobook. Today we start the second lesson of the class 11th, Biological Classification. Firstly, we move towards the introductory part of the biological classification. Since the dawn of civilization, there have been many attempts to classify living organisms. It was done instantly not using criteria that were scientific but born out of the needs to use the organisms for our own use, for food, shelter and clothing. Aristotle was the earliest to attempt a more scientific basis for classification. He used simple morphological characters to classify plants into trees, shrubs and herbs. He also divided animals into two groups, those which have red blood and those that did not. In Linnaeus' time, a two-kingdom system of classification with Plantae and Animalia kingdoms was developed that include all plants and animals respectively. This system did not distinguish between eukaryotes and prokaryotes, unicellular and multicellular organisms, and photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic organisms. Classification of the organism into plants and animals was easily done and was easy to understand, but a large number of organisms did not fall into either category. Hence, the two-kingdom classification used for a long time was found inadequate. Besides gross morphology, a need was also felt for including other characteristics like cell structure, nature of wall, mode of nutrition, habitat, methods of reproduction, evolutionary relationship, etc. Classification system for the living organisms have hence undergone several changes over the time. Through plants and animal kingdoms have been a constant under all different systems, the understanding of what group organisms be included under these kingdoms have been changing. The number and the nature of other kingdoms have also been understood differently by different scientists over the time. R. H. Whittaker in 1969 proposed a five-kingdom classification. The kingdom defined by him were named Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. The main criteria for classification used by him included cell structure, body organization, mode of nutrition, reproduction and phylogenetic relationships. Table 2.1 gives a comparative account of different characteristics of five kingdom. Let's see the table 2.1. In this table, cell type, cell wall, nuclear membrane body organization and mode of nutrition. On the basis of these characters, the organisms are divided. The three-domain system has also been proposed that divide the kingdoms Monera into two domains, leaving the remaining eukaryotic kingdoms in the third domain and thereby a six-kingdom classification. You will learn about this system in detail at higher classes. Let us look at this five-kingdom classification to understand the issues and considerations that influence the classification system. Earlier classification system included bacteria, blue-green algae, fungi, mosses, ferns, gymnosperm and the angiosperm under plants. The characters that unfitted this whole kingdom was that all the organisms included had a cell wall in their cells. These placed together groups which widely different in other characteristics. It brought together the prokaryotic bacteria and the blue-green algae. cyanobacteria with other group which were eukaryotic. It also grouped together the unicellular organisms and the multicellular ones, say for example Chlamydomonas and Spirogyra were placed together under algae. The classification did not differentiate between the heterotrophic group fungi and the autotrophic green plants, though they also showed a characteristics difference in their wall compositions. The fungi had chitin in their walls, while the green plants had cellulosic cell wall. When such characteristics were considered, the fungi were placed in a separate kingdom, kingdom fungi. All prokaryotic organisms were grouped together under kingdom Monera, and unicellular eukaryotic organisms were placed in kingdom Protista. Kingdom Protista has brought together Chlamydomonas, Chlorella, earlier placed in algae with plants and both having cell walls, and Paramecium and Amoeba, which were earlier placed in the animal kingdom which lack of cell wall. It has put together organisms which in earlier classification were placed in the different kingdoms. This happened because the criteria for classification changed. This kind of changes will take place in future too, depending on the improvement in our understanding of characteristics and evolutionary relationships. Over time, an attempt has been made to evolve the classification system which refers not only the morphological, physiological, and reproductive similarities, but is also phylogenic, that is, it's based on evolutionary relationships. In this chapter, we will study characteristics of kingdom Monera, Protista, and fungi of the Whittaker system of classification. The kingdom Plantae and Animalia, commonly referred to as plant and animals kingdom, respectively, will be dealt separately in chapter 3 and 4. 2.1 Kingdom Monera. Bacteria are the sole member of kingdom Monera. They are the most abundant microorganisms. Bacteria occurs almost everywhere. Hundreds of bacteria are present in the handful of soil. They also live in extreme habitats such as hot springs, deserts, snow and deep oceans, where a very few other life forms can survive. Many of them live in or on other organisms as parasites. Bacteria are grouped under four categories based on their shape: the spherical coccus, the rod shaped bacillus, the coma shaped vibrium or vibria, and the spiral spirulum or spirilla. Through the bacterial structure is very simple. They are very complex in behavior compared to many other organisms. Bacteria as a group show the most extensively metabolic diversity. Some of the bacteria are autotrophic, that is, they synthesize their own food from inorganic substance. They may be photosynthetic autotrophic or chemosynthetic autotrophic. The vast majority of bacteria are heterotrophs, that is, they depend on other organisms or on dead organic matter for food. 2.1.1 Archaeobacteria. These bacteria are special since they live in some of the most harsh habitats, such as extreme salty areas, halophils, hot spring, thermoacidophils, and marshy areas, methanogens. Archaeobacteria differed from other bacteria in having a different cell wall structure, and this feature is responsible for the survival of extreme conditions. Methanogens are present in the gut of several ruminants, animals such as cow and buffaloes, and they are responsible for the production of methane biogas from the dung of these animals. 2.1.2 Eubacteria. There are thousands of different Eubacteria or true bacteria. They are characterized by the presence of rigid cell wall and, if motile, a flagellum. The cyanobacteria, also referred as a blue-green algae, have chlorophyll A similar to green plants and are photosynthetic autotrophs. The cyanobacteria are unicellular, colonial or filamentous, freshwater or marine or terrestrial algae. The colonies are generally surrounded by gelatinous sheath. They often form blooms in the polluted water bodies. Some of these organisms can fix atmospheric nitrogen in specialized cells called heterocysts. Example, nostoc and anabina. Chemosynthetic autotrophic bacteria oxidized various inorganic substances such as nitrates, nitrites, and ammonia and use the released energy for their ATP production. They play a great role in recycling nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, and sulfur. Heterotrophic bacteria are also most abundant in nature. The majority are important decomposers. Many of them have a significant impact on human affairs. They are helpful in making curd from milk and production of antibiotics, fixing nitrogen in legume roots, etc. Some are pathogens causing damage to human beings, crops, farms, animals, and pets. Cholera, typhoid, tetanus, citrus canker are well-known diseases caused by different bacteria. Bacteria reproduce mainly by fission. Sometimes under unfavorable condition, they produce spores. They also reproduce by sort of sexual reproductions by adopting a primitive type of DNA transfer from one bacterium to another. The mycoplasma are organisms that completely lack of cell wall. They are the smallest living cells known and can survive without oxygen. Many mycoplasma are pathogenic in animals and plants. Here your Kingdom Monera is completed. If this video is useful to you, then please like, share and subscribe it. In next part, we talk about the another kingdom, Kingdom Protista.